Welcome to Ruby Thursday. I'm Melissa Wanish. In this series, we'll be taking you through getting a new Ruby on Rails app ready for development. I remember when I was first starting out on Ruby on Rails, I would work on a project for a little while and then want to start a new project, and I forgot how to do it. I would do the research and find out, but then I decided to create a cheat sheet so that it would make my life easier. And so I'm going to share that with you. And in this video, the first step is to get Ruby on Rails set up for development. Here we go. The first step is to open a terminal and check the versions of Ruby and Rails against production server params, or to make sure you're using the most recent stable versions. For example, Heroku is often just a little bit behind the most recent stable versions, and I've experienced where I've had to downgrade my version of Rails in order to use Heroku. There's a lot more documentation about upgrading than there is downgrading. For today, we'll go through checking the most recent stable versions and installing those. Let's jump to our terminal and see what Ruby version we have now. So that's Ruby /V. And then I use RVM to manage my Ruby packages, so that's RVM list known. And we'll scroll up and see that there is indeed a new version of Ruby, Ruby 2.2.1. So we will use RVM to install that. So it's RVM install Ruby 2.2.1. And this takes just a little bit of time, so I will fade out and jump to the end of the process. The next step is to check to make sure everything installed correctly. So let's do RVM list and see that our new Ruby version is showing. And let's make sure we're using it by typing Ruby-V. And there we have it. Now that we have a brand new version of Ruby, we need a brand new version of Rails. To do that, we type in gem install Rails. And this takes a little bit of time again, but not too long. And it's installed. So to check again, we have the new version, Rails-V, and we have the latest and greatest.
So now you have the latest and greatest versions of Ruby and Rails on your computer. Yay! The next step is to actually launch that app, and we'll do that in the next episode. If you have any questions or additions or anything else, be sure to leave a comment below. And if you don't have it already, be sure to click on this lovely button to receive your free Get Launching Cheat Sheet. Just put in your email address and I'll send it right over. You don't update Ruby and Rails every day, so I hope you found this video helpful. And if you think it'll benefit someone else, be sure to share. And if you're new here, be sure to click on the buttons below to sign up for my mailing list and to subscribe to my YouTube channel, so you can get all the Ruby Thursday awesomeness in your inbox. Thanks so much for watching. See you soon.